we have arrived at the Kairang Floating Market, and this boat we're gonna bump into in like 2 seconds is selling some pineapples. You can see the men up on the deck cutting up some pineapples. And there seems to be a rooster in there as well. Good morning to you too.
Including our tour, expertly carved up pineapple.
Welcome to this little boat right here. This is only like the beginning of the market, though we're not quite there yet.
I like the beginning.
Floating markets in southern Vietnam first came into existence to meet the trading needs of the locals at a time when road networks in the Mekong Delta were still in their infancy. Today, more than 100 years later, and in spite of widely developed road transportation, these floating markets are still thriving. Larger sized boats usually anchor themselves somewhere in the market, creating lanes for the smaller boats to weave through. So the Kairang Floating Market is the biggest floating market in the Delta. And over here in this part of Vietnam, the Mekong Delta is basically a way of life because the merchants that gather here every morning live on their boats. And you can also see that in the back of the boats. A lot of times they're cooking, they have some clothes hanging up to dry. Every morning they gather here with their boats and the stuff, of course, that they sell, the produce that they sell. A lot of the merchants here are wholesalers, so they're selling to other smaller merchants for retail or for whatever. At the front of every boat, you will find a huge upright pole that basically shows off the merchandise that the boat is selling. So if they're selling fruit, there will be fruit hanging on that pole. If they're selling clothing, there will be clothing on there. If you're selling anything else, whatever it is, it'll be up there as an advertisement and so that people know what they can find on the boat. They don't yell to people passing by or to boats passing by, because those sounds would get lost in the vastness of the river and in the sounds of the other boats. We just went past the fruit part, I think it is. So initially we thought that maybe you're just cruising along for a little bit to switch between different parts of the market. Not really so sure about that now, because we've been on the boat without spotting any floating market activities for a while now, but there are supposed to be parts where you can get some pho, where you can get coffee, where you can get pretty much anything, live animals. We haven't seen that yet, so fingers crossed. This is like the second part of a floating market. It's a small, tiny bit that has a few boats that seem to be selling coconuts, some pho, some fruits, but there seem to be more tourist boats here actually than boats are actually selling stuff, so far it's still a bit weird.
We just ordered 2 pho's. We got hooked into that little boat here next to us. Ladies preparing the pho on the boat. First time. We're in a small boat. I'm going to eat pho. Prepared a lady in an even smaller boat. Got a delicious bowl of steaming hot pho. It's really cool that you can come here with your boat and just row up here and then have some pho. Thank you. Yeah. Very good.
Yeah, come on.
Come on. Come in. Come in is a Vietnamese word for thank you.
Okay, what did you have on your head?
Bye-bye. I just got this hat from, I don't know, our boat lady. I think she made it for us or bought it for us so we can look extra touristy.
You look very regal.
I also have this to go with my hat, I guess.
So far, I mean, I'm a bit disappointed with the floating markets, but I expected way more of it. I expected it to be bigger, more like authentic. I don't know what you think, or is that just me?
That's pretty much the same for me. I like the first part a lot, was really nice. Second part felt very touristy. I love the scenery here on the way back. It's really nice. It's small little canals, you're very close to the houses. It's very lush, very green. Anyway, time for some mini bananas.
We just got out of the boat, she was like, walking 5 minutes. Actually, I think she's still around. I think she's like following us with the boat because the river is like right here. There she is. And I think we're just passing through this homestay right now, which looks pretty nice. You can have some coffee here, you can have some food here. Still quite full from the pho and from the chicken embryo.